When you hear what the step is, you might think that it's a no-brainer, but trust me, it's probably the most important as well as the most overlooked. If you're new to this channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe and notification buttons as I do post new content every week. It would really help me out and hey, it also won't cost you anything. Now, what do you think the most overlooked step is? Please go ahead and put it in the comments below, because when you hear what it is, you might think that it's a no-brainer. But trust me, a lot of data governance leads, or enthusiasts as I call them, skip this step and they just take it upon themselves to put together a business glossary. Commendable? For sure. Appreciated? Yes. Successful? Not for the most part. It's not always the best strategy to go ahead and run with something without buy-in. Yes, the most overlooked step is getting the buy-in. You need to get that buy-in in order to secure a long-term success for your business glossary. So don't just jump over this one. There are three areas to tackle as part of securing your buy-in. You need to put together a business case. This is really a document memorializing the business purpose of the business glossary and emphasizing the challenges of not having one. There are plenty. Don't make it more than 1 or 2 pages long, as it's usually used for executive communication. And how enthusiastically do you think an executive will read a document longer than that? Okay, maybe if it's a financial report, but this is not that. Speaking of executives, you also need to get a sponsor. As with any project, you should get a sponsor. You need someone higher up to keep pushing the project. The sponsor should be someone at least at a director level, because you not only need financial support, but also involvement and participation from your entire organization. Okay, not everyone will or should contribute with content to it, but you do want everyone using it. So the higher up this individual is on the organization hierarchy chain, the better. Again, the sponsor should be at least at a director level, but first try to aim for a VP or a C-level executive. Before we go any further, I'd like to thank the sponsor of this video, Dataedo. Dataedo allows you to catalog, document, and understand your data with a data dictionary, a business glossary, and ER diagrams. Go get a free trial and check them out for yourself. Additionally, use the following coupon code for a 10% discount on your purchase. The links are in the video's description, so start boosting your data and software initiatives today. Lastly, you also need some budget assigned to this project. You need budget in order to set everything up, to learn and discover best practices, maintain the business glossary, evolve it, and ideally have a tool so you can manage it more efficiently. With a specialized tool, you can also integrate with some data management tools, such as a data dictionary, a data catalog, even a data quality or reporting tools. It all depends on what your scope is, how evolved your data governance program is, and how much available budget you have access to. But the good thing is that there are different options for different needs. So don't jump over this step, because as you can see, it's quite important. In a later video, I will go over the 5 main steps to implement a business glossary. Until then, check out LightsOnData.com. Here you can find more informative content such as templates and guides, best practices, articles, and other useful resources to help you with your data governance and data management questions and challenges. Please like the video if you've enjoyed it, and don't forget to subscribe to never miss out on great content. Thank you.